Anybody else?
My name's Peter Cobal, I'm at 115 Narragansett Avenue. I am going to be reading a letter that has been addressed to you, so I'm going to give you all a copy of it now. It'll be the third part of my little thing here. One of the questions I have, back in the '70s and '80s, we had an on-call ACO, Charlie Bursey. We had a part-time ACO, Jack Albo. But now you're saying there's no need for an ACO with a population in Jamestown that has doubled, I think, since the '70s. And the population of animals and people is a lot more. And one of the questions I have, do we have a written agreement with the town of North Kingston saying that their ACO will handle our animal problems?
No, we don't have a written agreement.
You guys have a written agreement?
We're considering a couple of options, Peter. One is,
Can we hold these weeks still?
Oh, sure.
Are there budget discussions?
We got budget discussions on Thursday, but we're looking at a couple of options with respect to where the call resources would come from, one island or off island.
I'd like to read a letter addressed to the town council from Dr. Maxon Ballford, North Kingston Animal Hospital. Dr. Ballford is the doctor of veterinary medicine that works with the NK Town and the NK's ACO to manage the medical care for the animals at that facility. It states, "Dear Jamestown Town Council, it is important to have an animal control officer in the town of Jamestown. To do away with this position would be seriously detrimental to the town. An animal control officer maintains order to the town's animal population and enforces the bylaws of the freedoms concerning them. Please do not let funding come into the way of such a necessity. As a doctor of veterinary medicine in the town of North Kingston, I am concerned with the consequences this poor choice may play on an already drained animal control agency. I do not see how practically the town of Jamestown could be regulated without its own dog officer. Many of our clients that reside in Jamestown are concerned that this position may be dropped. Sincerely, Dr. Maxon Ballford." I agree with Sam that there's a ton of ways you can trim the budget. Two chiefs, I didn't think he was a chief, but I know that I saw in one of your budget meetings that we spent $26,000 on a car for the lieutenant to have to drive back and forth from Exeter to work. Most people I know that have jobs have to drive their own car and spend their own money for gas. I'm really not convinced, Mr. Tyson, that this isn't a witch hunt for the ACO.
All right, thank you. Any other non-scheduled requests to address?
I do have a question for Mr. Kaiser. He was kind enough to speak to me earlier today. I'm troubled over one of the answers you gave. I asked you why Captain Gregory, out of seven women in the police station, could not use the bathroom for the rest of the girls and the facility in the locker room in case she had to change the uniform due to animal blood or any other thing. You told me she could use the public. Well, I have a problem with that. I wouldn't, I told you, I didn't do it. When I was in uniform for 20 years, and I looked at when I retired, I wouldn't have treated any of my people like that. I resent that you say she can use the public one for the other six women, secretaries, dispatchers, three patrol people. Could use everything, but you single out the captain, and I resent it as a taxpayer for 44 years. And that's all I have to say, because you gave me the answer, that's what you choose.
Thank you. Any other requests, non-scheduled requests to address? I hope this doesn't turn into another animal control officer tonight.
It is an ACO position. Question.
Real quick, please.
We want to know if the ACO position is still in the budget.
Name and address.
Louis Patello, 6 Ferry Street.
Yeah.
Is it still in the budget?
We haven't finalized the budget yet.
All right. We, the residents of Jamestown, would like to vote on it. Do you June 7th.
Thank you. Any other non-scheduled?
Sydney Gregory, 115 Bayview Drive. I would like to read a letter that was delivered to our home on Christmas Eve, 2007.
No. I won't allow this. Thank you.
Is there a reason?
We're not reading personnel letters in open forum. We're not discussing personnel matters here. Thank you. Any other non-scheduled requests to address?